On November 29, 2001, the world woke up to the news that legendary Beatle George Harrison had died after a short battle with lung cancer at the age of just 58.
The former Beatle died in Los Angeles, his family by his side.
Now, world-renowned forensic pathologist Dr. Michael Hunter is re-examining the case to find out how George developed the disease and how he died so quickly from a potentially treatable form of it.
So far, I've discovered that Harrison was a heavy smoker, one of the biggest causes of lung cancer. But smokers normally develop the disease in their 70s. So I believe there could be other factors to his death. And I can see from biographical accounts that the 1970s were a troubling decade for George.
In 1970, George Harrison and his wife Patty Boyd bought Friar Park, the ultimate rock star retreat.
The house is magnificent. It's a Gothic mansion.
Having met George while working at Apple Records, Chris O'Dell was invited to move in.
He said, "It's so big, would you like to come out?" While living at Friar Park, George and Patty became like a brother and sister to me.
After the breakup of the Beatles, Friar Park became a sanctuary for an increasingly reclusive George.
He didn't like going out to dinners, and he didn't like going to parties. And when they moved into Friar Park, that was pretty isolated.
It also became the ideal place to work on his first solo album, All Things Must Pass.
When the album came out, it was the best thing that had happened to him. Probably better than even the Beatles being successful.
The number one album meant that by 1973, and still just 30 years old, Harrison appeared to enjoy an unparalleled level of success. But behind the scenes, the pressure of going it alone with a solo career was taking its toll.